Okay, excellent. Alright, so GML round 5, and it's the final game or set of the week. And we do have Fiege versus Timp. Fiege in teal, spawning as Huns down to the bottom of the map, and his opponent CKF Timp in red up to the north is as Mongols. We actually don't have a Civ War on this map, and it's kind of interesting that Timp has chosen Mongols. We'll see how it plays out for him, but the map is Baltic, and this is Fiege's choice of home map. The next game will be Timp's choice of home map. We'll have to see what he goes for, but for the time being we will have Baltic right here, and we do have Fiege versus Timp, and I'm looking forward to this one. I don't really know the relationship between Fiege and Timp. For instance, we know for a fact that Fiege and the Viper have Timp and the Viper have quite a bit of rivalry between them. I think Timp and Fiege are quite neutral to each other. I believe they were both on Team RVK at one point. So whether or not they're actually friends, I don't know. Whether they know a lot about each other's sort of strategies, I don't know. But one thing is kind of interesting, the fact that Timp has chosen to play Mongols on this map. And I don't know really if that's going to work out in favour of him at all. It could be quite risky choice, I think, because you've got to consider, Mongols are not going to be as great on water as, for instance, Huns. Huns don't have to build houses, and the wood that they save from that can be invested into docks and fishing ships and galleys. So he can actually accelerate his production on water just by not having to build those houses and spend 30 wood every minute or so, whatever, however often he needs to build houses. So that's kind of a nice advantage for him. The advantage for Timp, however, is that maybe he'll be able to get up to the feudal age a little bit faster, because he does have an increased hunt gathering time, which is wild boar and deer. But really, I don't think that's going to make so much of a difference that it's going to put Timp in a massive lead this game. So I'm kind of intrigued to see where he's going to go with this, and I think Mongols is quite an interesting choice for this map. We've already seen Timp play against Jordan23 on Baltic. Jordan chose Baltic against Timp, and we saw Timp suffer in that game. Jordan was really, really strong. Timp lost the water. He didn't even attempt to take the water, and Jordan ended up winning that game. Fiege co-casted that game with me, and perhaps he's chosen Baltic against Timp because he saw his performance in Baltic the previous time round, and he might have thought to himself, you know what, this could be a good opportunity for me to take a game from Timp quite early in this set. So this is indeed the first game, and they're going to be playing this one and getting things underway pretty shortly. I just think though that Fiege is going to be pretty strong in this map. He kind of knows that Timp is not so great on this map perhaps, and maybe he could find himself in a nice position. But I've got a little feeling that Timp might be up to something here. I don't know if he's going to bother taking the water at all. He might decide to send a forward like he did in the last game with Jordan, and because he's Mongols, he could actually get some scouts into Fiege's economy if Fiege doesn't wall. So if Fiege is quite quick to wall up, then of course Timp is going to be struggling to get through. But if Fiege does wall up, then Timp could actually, doesn't wall up even, Timp could go for a little bit of a scout rush. We'll see how that works out for him. And a nice one from Fiege, just intersecting a couple of sheep, send them back to his TC for a little bit of a food boost. He's got deer quite close to his TC as well, so he could actually hunt those quite easily. And he's going to take Loom and then go to the feudal age. He should be just about ready to get up in just a sec. Idle TC for a second there, but now he's going up, and Timp should be, yeah, he's on his way up as well, slightly faster, probably due to the fact that he can gather from his boars a bit faster, and he's not decided to take deer, but this is interesting. He's going to be up to the feudal age first, and he might actually be in with a little bit of a good shout on taking the water here. We'll see how it works out for him. He's only gone for 3 fishing ships, so he's not invested so heavily into the ships, and he's got a little bit more wood left over. I think he's probably going to be adding on another dock pretty shortly. Villager is going over there right now, and she is going to go to build a dock. She is gathering shorefish, but in comes Fiege with his scout. I thought for a second there he would attack that villager and try and maybe slow the dock down, but Timp's coming over to intersect that, and Fiege is not going to be able to pick that one off. He is, however, going to get another dock up, well, Timp is, as Fiege is getting his second as well, and we're definitely going to see some grushing this game. It's just a question of who is going to take the water control, and how are they going to deal with that. The age is a little bit slower to get up to the feudal age. Tim already up right now, and the first galley is coming out. He can't afford to make two straight away, but now he just about can. And Fiege is going to be making two of his own as well. So it's very, very close on water right now. Fiege could lose his scout just here, and that would be a little bit bad for him, although it's not the end of the world. He does know where Tim is. He's managed to get quite a lot of scouting information. And, well, actually, no, he's not got all that much, but at the moment, it's not so necessary for him to know exactly what's going on at Tim's base, because he does know he's going to go for a Grush, and he can probably gauge by Tim's Grush exactly how well he's doing on the water and whether Tim is going to be sending any sneak villagers around. For instance, if Tim stops making galleys, or he has very little resistance on the water, then he's going to assume that Tim is going to try and land him or sneak some villagers. So we'll see how it goes, but the first galley's going to come out right now, and Fiege is a fraction of a second behind getting those galleys out, but it shouldn't make too much of a difference. He's already got two out on the water, as has Tim, and he might just be able to defend his fishing ships here if Tim doesn't focus them down. He should be alright for the time being, though. His third dock is up, as is Tim's, and it doesn't look like Tim is going to give up on the water straight away this game, which is good for Tim, because last game he really, really struggled because of it. We'll see how it ends up going. Going to start trying to take the water right now. Fiege, just pretty much standard water start. At the moment, 5 villagers to gold, most of his villagers to wood. Pretty much the same for Tim as well, most to wood over here. And only three villagers to gold for Tim, but he should have plenty of gold income to still create enough galleys. They do build quite slowly, and that does allow you to get enough gold in. And Fiege gonna go in there. It looks like he may just be able to pick off a galley here if he's got a little bit of micro. He's gonna have to run away though, because he's outnumbered 3-2, but he's gonna bring two more in, and he does have the 3 docks. Is he gonna add a 4th dock though? That is the interesting thing. He's got a villager here gathering some shorefish, so he might actually add the 4th dock pretty soon. Tim could do the same. He's got plenty of wood, and they're actually fairly close for wood at the moment, so I think interesting. Fiege not going to go for the 4th dock just yet. Tim could go for the 4th dock with this villager, but nope, just going to go for houses. And of course, all those houses are costing Tim. That's a lot of wood spent in these houses so far, and that's the wood that Fiege can invest in galleys right now. So Fiege going to be off to a nice start. He's already got more galleys out on the water, it seems, and if Tim does lose the water here, it's going to be pretty tough for him. And just keep an eye on the edges of the maps to see, of the map even, to see if Tim is trying to sneak any villagers at any point. 4th dock going down for Fiege, and not only does Fiege gain a huge advantage if he wins the water, but he might even be able to castle faster than Tim will if he does do that, because the fishing ship's going to give him a huge boost on the water, and that should really help him out in the long run. Tim seems to be sticking with the 3 docks for now. He's got plenty of wood though, so he can actually create a lot more galleys, but it seems like he stopped galley production. Nope, he's just adding them in pretty slowly, but I actually thought for a second there that Tim was going to go for 4 docks. He's now up against 4 docks from Fiege, and I can't see how he's going to win the water now, unless he does some incredible out microing. Fiege is definitely going to gain the galley advantage very shortly, and he should, in theory, be able to win the water. It's 3 docks against 4. There's no reason why Fiege wouldn't win the water here. Tim starting to take the deer down this side as well. Looks like he's getting a little bit low on food. He's using fishing ships to gather shore fish, which isn't so effective as taking the big fish in the middle, of course. Fiege now going to push out again, I think, in just a second. I thought he was getting ready to push out there. He should have enough galleys. It looks like, yep, blacksmith up for him, sorry, for Tim even. So he's going to be getting fletching as soon as he can afford it, but he's a little bit low on food at the moment. Fiege still without a blacksmith just yet, so fletching won't be done for a while for him, but it should still go in favour of Fiege on the water here. He's outnumbering Tim about 2-1, and I can't see Tim actually taking the water at all. We'll just have to speed things up and see if he manages to. Blacksmith from Fiege, fletching straight away, and Tim might be waiting for fletching before he engages. He's actually not researching it. Yeah, there we go. He's just getting it now. And even though he got the blacksmith up first, he was struggling for food for a little bit. He was struggling for gold for a little bit. And he actually couldn't afford fletching at all there. So it looks like Fiege is going to have fletching advantage for a second until it's researched for Tim, but he's still creating a lot of galleys, and it still looks like he's going to be outnumbering Tim. Every minute the game passes, he's going to be outnumbering him by a bigger margin, and Tim's going to have to do something here. He's going to have to do something different. He can't just rely on these three docks to win the game. VH gonna push out now. He's gonna perhaps snipe these or kill these fishing ships. It looks like Tim could get VH's fishing ships if he was to move over here, because as soon as he sees VH at his docks, he will maybe go straight for VH's fishing ships to try and even the field there. But it looks like VH with plenty of ships on the water. I think Tim probably realizes at this stage he's not got enough galleys out. It's actually 13 for Tim. VH on 18, so he definitely does have an advantage in that respect, and it's a lot easier to see what's going on the water when we actually have it on this cam, or this view even. And it looks like VH could even trap Tim here. If he forces Tim into the corner, he's going to have him cornered, and he should be able to finish him off. He just needs to stay on this side of him and force him down here. And if Tim gets trapped against the shoreline, then VH is definitely going to be able to kill off the rest of these galleys. And this could end up being quite a short game, because Tim, obviously after playing Jordan, knows what happens when he loses the water, and he might fear the same already. VH getting really nice and close in there, and he's going to finish all of these galleys off. It's like a one-shot kill for most of them, and Tim losing his navy. He's got a few ships back at home, but it's nothing compared to the navy of VH right now. And if he does corner him down here, which it looks like he might just do if VH just turns around, very close, it looks like he is gonna finish these guys off. And Tim moving over now, I think he might be looking for some fishing ships from VH, but all the fishing ships from VH are already dead, so Tim gonna have to move in with these guys, see if he can pick off any of the stragglers here. But he's gonna find himself cornered in just a second. Nice maneuvering from VH there, anticipating where Tim's gonna go, and he should be able to finish off the rest of these galleys no problem, as I just can't see, yeah, there's no way that Tim is going to be able to win that. He is going to be able to take out a few for free back here though, VH bringing in a few reinforcements, but the majority of Tim's galleys have been taken out, and now I'm just waiting to see what Tim is going to do. He's looking a little bit bad over here. He's running out of deer to take, and his economy is still mainly gold and wood, so he could still be creating galleys, but he's not. And he's going to have to do something different here. He can't just sit in his base without producing galleys. He knows he's lost the water now. There's no way he's going to be able to gain it back at all. And VH can start to produce some fishing ships once he clears up the rest of these galleys. He might even just finish off these docks to make sure Tim isn't going to be doing anything sneaky like that. But now VH is stone walled, so even if Tim decides that he's going to come in and do some land attack, he's not going to really be able to do that, because VH has stone walled himself in. And if Tim decides to try and sneak a villager, it's just not going to work. He did just build a market though. It looks like he could be selling off some resources and buying some resources to try and get up to the castle age a little bit faster. So he's going to be up to castle now, but it's really not that fast, because VH already clicked up before him, and VH looking really strong in this map right now. He's going to take out these docks from Tim, and if Tim loses his docks, there's not really much chance for him to get the docks back unless he puts a tower on the shoreline or a castle or something. And Tim now going to have to find some way to break down these walls and get into VH's base. He could try and go for a landing, but VH can easily split his ships up and cover the shoreline of Tim and make sure he's not putting any sneak docks anywhere at all. Tim's only real option if he wants to get into VH's base is to put a siege workshop or a few archery ranges, and a few archery ranges even down here, or even a stable and make some knights and try and break through this wall with a ram or something. But VH is going to see it coming a mile off. If we have a look at his vision, he's got a little bit of vision there. He'll be able to react in time, I think, unless there's so many rams that he's just not going to be able to do it. But I can't see that being the case at all. Tim going to lose his docks here pretty shortly, and VH is going to be able to add in more fishing ships as soon as he's cleared up the rest of the galleys from Tim. It looks like he's actually adding some more in already. As long as he doesn't lose this one, he'll be absolutely fine. Is he going to lose it? No, so close. But he's still got four left, and he can easily add some more in if he wants as well. But VH there with a transport ship. Looks like he's going to send some villagers over once he reaches the castle age and try and put some pressure on Tim at his base. Tim, with so much resources now, he's not spending his wood at all. I'm not really sure what he's doing here. He's got a lot of wood saved up. He's got a lot of food and gold saved up as well. And it's certainly not looking so good for him at the moment. He might decide to move some villagers away from wood here, but his economy is certainly pretty imbalanced. He's got way too many wood collectors for what he needs at the moment, and unless he's just going to do something out of the ordinary, I can't see what he's got planned for this. VH now up to the castle age before Tim, of course, and we see War Galley being researched. I'm surprised he's not adding in some more docks of his own, but he has got the transport ship here with the villagers, and Tim is not walled, and that is weird. You wouldn't expect him to not be walled like that, and now putting a couple of town centres down, so he's just trying to boom and outboom VH and try and get back into the game that way, it seems. Still a ton of wood, though, and if he continues to keep gathering wood, then he's going to find himself really unbalanced. But VH coming forwards with a couple of archery range, of course he is Huns, which just means that he's going to be putting some cavalry archers into the back of Tim's base very shortly. Tim though, with two town centres going up pretty quickly, and he might just be able to keep his villagers safe for the time being, but VH with the water control now will be able to add the fishing ships. I'm just waiting for him to start adding them. He is adding a few when he can afford it. At the moment though, he's going to be wanting to save a little bit of his wood for cavalry archers, I think. But the cavalry archers are going to come out, and VH likely to be able to pick a few villagers off, though these town centres are going to make it a little bit more awkward. And Tim's still taking a ton of wood. He's actually spent it now, though, actually, because he is going to seed a lot of farms. And Tim making a monastery back here. He might be going for relics. He might be trying to make monks to convert whatever VH sends his way. But it looks like VH now with three archery ranges, he might even put a siege workshop down, should be able to push through and actually take out a lot of these villagers. I don't really know what Tim's strategy here is to do. He's not going to be able to achieve much by sitting in his base and booming. Perhaps he might reach the Imperial Age first, but VH putting the pressure on, he's going to find a way to get into Tim's base and cause a lot of troubles. There really isn't going to be a lot Tim can do. He's sitting on 40 CS here, he's going to be booming a lot, but VH making army, he's got a 1,000 score lead, and he will find a way in. He has got Bodkin Arrow, which does mean he has extra 2 range, and he will be able to start picking away at villagers and just harassing Tim's eco to the point where it's just not going to be possible for him to really do that much. He's still not making any military whatsoever. We've got a monk coming out from him here, though, and he might get a couple of conversions. But against cavalry archers, monks not so effective as they would be against knights. And Tim just trying to wall himself off a little bit with houses back here. But it looks like VH is going to be able to get right in this little gap, kill a few more villagers fairly easily. And let's look at Tim's vision. He's going to see this now, and is he going to react quick enough? Yep, he reacted. He's got the vision there, and VH is going to be forced to retreat. So this could actually work a little bit for Tim if he just keeps his villagers safe and out booms VH. But VH isn't dull tool. He is quite a sharp tool in that box. He's going to be adding town centres of his own on, and he's probably going to take a little bit of stone to catch up in TCs, but he is going to be able to add more fishing ships. I keep saying this, and every time I check he's not, but he is making more because there is more on the water, and he's just going to gain a huge advantage because of that. Able to convert one cavalry archer, but he took the monk out as well. And for Huns, it's kind of okay to get one cavalry archer converted. They're pretty cheap, and a tower for VH as well. Looks like it might go up just before Tim's as well, which does mean that he should be able to keep his villagers nice and safe there, be able to pressure this. And now Tim is finding himself in a little bit of a bad situation. VH is going to be able to hit and run from multiple angles, and he should be able to kill off a few more villagers. He could bring some cavalry archers around this side, maybe pick off some farmers, or bring them even around here and go for the gold. But another town centre for Tim on this gold right here, and Tim is going for 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Five town centres when this one is up. He will have 5, and that is pretty insane. 5 CCs from Tim, and Tim is just playing super, super defensively. He's turtling up, and he's trying to keep VH out, but VH is going to keep harassing from the shores. Once he gets Imperial, these will be galleons with their Bodkin Arrow. They'll be able to attack even more inland. and he's just generally in the lead in every respect, apart from town centres. He does have less town centres, but he is adding his third one right now. He has still got these cavalry archers around Tim's base. Tim, still with no military whatsoever. He might be trying to go for a castle, and... oh, is he going to get a couple of villages here? He could do. There's one, perhaps. One, two... oh, just going to have to run away there, taking too much damage from these TCs. And Fia just going to be a little bit cautious here. He's thinking, hang on a minute, Tim's got 5 TCs. What is Fia going to be able to do here? He's going to be able to keep putting pressure on, but whether he's going to be able to do that much damage, I'm not sure. But Tim, looks like he's going to go for a castle over here. And if he gets a castle on the shore, he could actually force Fia back and put some docks back down. And if he reaches the Imperial Age first, then again, he could be in a nice little a little situation, but it's a little bit early to say whether that's going to work or not. Fiege on 103 population, Tim on 70, and so I'd say their economies are fairly even at this stage. Tim, of course, going to have more villages sooner, but Fiege up to 3 TCs. He might even add another one on, because he sees how many Tim has got, but he still does have water, and he's still got quite a lot of fishing ships in the centre, bringing in a lot of food for him, and it could be alright. Tim, though, gonna have enough for a castle right now. He might plonk the castle down on the shoreline, maybe here or something. No, he's gonna put it back. So he's gonna put a castle back here. I thought maybe he'd go a little bit closer to the shore, but he's gonna play it a little bit more defensively, not risk his villagers dying. And this castle's gonna go up. He should be able to make a few Mangadai and maybe pick off the cavalry archers from Fiege. I don't know if he's getting any researches or upgrades, but it doesn't look like it right now. Fiege going to spot the castle, of course, and he knows that Tim is going to be playing it so defensively here. But Fiege still with a huge score lead, and that's likely to be mostly due to these galleys and the cavalry archers. But this castle is going to go up, and that's going to take down this watchtower from Fi as well. But whether Tim creates a lot of Mangadai or not, I'm not sure. Let's have a look. He probably won't just yet. He's probably going to save and wait till he gets to the Imperial Age. But the castle is going to provide a little bit more protection, and indeed, he's not going to be making any more Mangadai just yet. A siege workshop from Tim as well. Going to be trying to get a couple of mangonels out, perhaps. And Tim could even add another castle pretty shortly. He's got a load of stone coming in still, and he could probably afford another castle fairly soon. His population's still quite far behind Fiege, though. Fiege 117, Tim on 87, and he's struggling for military at the moment. Fiege going to have to play close attention to his cavalry archers, though, I think, because if a mangonel does come out, then Tim is going to be able to flatten a lot of these guys if he's not paying attention properly. But at the moment, Tim's economy is still a little bit unbalanced. So much gold and some mangonel starting to be created. And he's got plenty of gold now, so he could actually reach Imperial pretty shortly. Another castle going up on the right, and Tim really is just turtling up. Our mangonel just about to come out as well, and I think that Tim is perhaps going to reach Imperial Age pretty soon. We'll have to see. He's going to click up in just a moment. He needs another 100. There we go. He's just bought a little bit of food there, and he's clicked up to Imperial. Fiege, on the other hand, let's have a look. Is he anywhere near to the Imperial Age? Nope, just not just yet. He needs another 400 food at least, and another 300 gold. But he does have quite a lot of units out already. Just needs to avoid the mangonel fire from Tim. He could easily get in there and prevent that from going up. And another castle from Tim as well. And it might actually start to be Tim's turtling that's actually starting to pay off. It looks like Tim going to be continuing to make Mangadai. He's completing a few more over at this castle here. He might be queuing up a few more on this side. He's a little bit low on wood right now, but it looks like he's going to be able to afford the third castle pretty shortly as well. And he's starting to gain a little bit more control of what is going on. In comes Fiege from the back. A nice little reaction from Tim there, realizing Fiege where he's at. Fiege's going to get one villager. But Tim now, on the way up to the Imperial Age, might just be able to hold on. VH not that far behind. He's going to be Imperial shortly after. We can see Heavy Cavalry Archer coming straight out for him. And, of course, he still does have the water control. And he's starting to wall off a little bit further forward as well to make sure he keeps that map control. Mangadai over this side. And he's going to see the Mangadai there. He probably assumes Tim's going to go Mangadai anyway, because Mangadai are pretty darn good. They're one of my favourite units, actually. VH still hanging around on this hill, stopping Tim from gathering any more stone. But Tim, I think, could be on his way with his third castle right now. And it's over on this left-hand side. Going to secure this gold nice and easy. And he should be able to even collect up this relic if he gets that castle up. Although there isn't really any threat from VH on that side of the map. And Tim now going to reach Imperial very shortly. Let's see if he's actually able to do much when he reaches Imperial. We could see Elite Mangadai pretty shortly. It's not that much to upgrade. It just costs food and gold, which does mean that you can create even more because it doesn't cost wood at all. And he might go straight with Elite. He might just start to mass them up. And he's reached Imperial right now, which is pretty darn good. And VH is going to be slightly further behind, but not so far behind that it's going to cause huge problems. Let's see what he does when he does reach Imperial. But at the moment, Tim going to be upgrading at the Blacksmith. Bracer coming up right there. Plenty of Mangadais coming out as well. He can't afford Elite just yet. He needs a little bit more food. I think the Elite upgrade is something like 1,200 food and 650 gold or something. It's quite a lot of food, but the gold cost isn't too high. Bracer just being completed right there. And we might see some archer armor on the way as well. But VH up to the Imperial Age straight away. What is he doing? What's he got planned? Bracer, of course. At the docks, are we going to see anything else? We're seeing War Guardians coming out. He's getting a little bit cautious now, thinking that perhaps Tim might try and retake the water. That could be the case. Not seeing Heavy Cavalry Archer just yet. We're not seeing Chemistry just yet. VH is struggling for resources, it actually seems. He's not got much gold left at all. And it looks like Tim's turtling method might actually just pay off. It's a little bit of a long shot, but it could work. He's got a much bigger economy. He's researching Elite Mangadai just now, and he might even have more military units on the map pretty shortly as well. Ballistics just being researched over here. More Mangadai is coming out. Elite Mangadai almost finished. Archer armor being researched as well. These guys are going to be upgraded pretty shortly. A little bit of a fun fact. Mangadais are actually the only... Well, sorry. They are the unit in the game that the most upgrades apply to. Elite Mangadais have something like 15 or 16 upgrades that can be applied to them. Of course, the Elite Mangadai upgrade, conscription upgrade, well, no, I don't know if you can count conscription, but all the archer armor upgrades, you have Parthian Tactics that's going to come up at the blacksmith, sorry, not the blacksmith, at the archery range, Bloodlines, which affects them, Ballistics, which affects them, Chemistry, which affects them. There's so many upgrades to the Mangadai, Thumb Ring, which affects them, and they are easily a very, very powerful unit once they are fully upgraded. And Tim's going to have a big economy to afford all those upgrades. They do cost a hell of a lot, and there are a lot of upgrades to get to actually fully upgrade these Mangadai over here. We'll see the stable there. That's probably going to be getting Bloodlines fairly shortly. And, of course, he still needs Chemistry as well. I believe Archery Range going up at the back there, so Parthian Tactics going to come out of that one, as well as a Thumb Ring. And if Tim does fully upgrade these guys, not only do they have the faster firing speed from the civilization bonus, plus the Thumb Ring upgrade, which increases their firing speed as well, they are going to be quite formidable against cavalry archers from Huns. So we could be in a decent spot here. There's the stable with Bloodlines coming up right away. We could see some more out of the university and archery range pretty shortly, but in comes VH, going to be met with a castle. He's not really going to get in there at all. He's trying to have a little bit of a poke, but it's not going to be so effective. Elite skirmishers, they even get flattened by Mangadai once they get massed up enough. There's Thumb Ring being researched at the archery range right now. And these Mangadai's soon going to be fully upgraded. It's just a matter of time. And Tim is working on these upgrades, but he's still going to be very hard-pressed to defend. VH, with such a huge score at the moment, his economy is fairly strong. He's going to be upgrading his cavalry archers. I'm surprised he's not got heavy cavalry archers just yet. Chemistry about to complete. Blacksmith upgrades nearly completed. He's missing a few defensive upgrades there. And there come the Mangadai. And the Mangadai is so, so strong. VH has already upgraded Galleon. And he's going to be able to defend the coastline a little bit more. Tim losing a few Mangadai there, throwing them away, but starting to actually catch up on Viage, which is like amazing. Sorry about that. Viage actually starting to catch up. Tim actually starting to catch up, and I just can't believe he's managing to come back from this position. You'd think when he lost the water that was pretty much it. Husbandry, that applies to them as well. Parthian tactics being researched right there, and these Mangadai is going to be so strong in just a moment. Scale Barding Armor being researched. I think that might have been a misclick, because that's not the one that applies to Mangadai. He does need the Ring Archer Armor if he wants to apply this. Tim, population caps on 154. Viage almost at population limit now. And he's getting very defensive here, making a lot of walls to make sure Tim does not get through. And that is a lot of walling, Viage. I was not expecting that many walls from him, but I guess he's a little bit on edge now. He's thinking perhaps Tim might push me back and end up taking this game. We'll have to see. What is Viage's strategy here? Making Cavalier, we might see Paladin from him fairly soon. Heavy Cavalry Archer not upgraded yet. I don't think he doesn't think that Cavalry Archers are going to be good enough to beat what Tim has at the moment. A lot of Mangadais, that is what he has, but he's been population capped for quite a while, and that is kind of interesting. Chain Barding Armor being researched. It looks like he might go for some Hussars, actually. He's researched Light Cavalry already. We could see Hussar from him, and we could see a Hussar plus Mangadai army coming out of Tim right here, and that could be fairly strong, especially against Cavalry Archers and Skirmishers. If Viage starts to add some Paladins, it could make it a little bit more awkward. Tim's starting to push out on the right, and he's actually closed the gap in score quite a large bit as well. Tim looking actually quite good for the first time in this game. I actually believe that maybe, just maybe, he could hold on here. He's almost got these guys fully upgraded. He just needs chemistry now, and I think he will be about there. He's got 3k gold in the bank, and the Mangadais are going to come over and pick off these galleons like there is no tomorrow, because Mangadais surprisingly actually kill galleons quite easily. You might even see that in action right now. There we go. Mangadais fighting galleons. They are going to get flattened still, but they are going to kill off a lot of galleons, and he might just be able to cause enough of a distraction here to put this castle up even. Looks like the castle is going to complete, and he's done what he needs to do. The castle goes up, and he's secured a little bit more stone on the right hand side. He's secured a little bit more coastline, and Viage now is going to have to react pretty quickly. Is he making upgrading Paladin? Nope, not just yet. He's stuck on Cavalier. Is he upgrading Heavy Cavalry Archer? Nope, he's totally going to scrap that. But he has got Trebuchets firing down on this castle. And Tim is going to lose that if he's not careful. He doesn't actually have much stone in the bank to repair it. So it could go down, and Tim might start to be whittled away. But I've got to say, Viage without that much army at the moment. Most of his army is galleons, and the rest of it is cavaliers, which still aren't going to put up to that much abuse from Mangadai, especially now they are fully upgraded. But he does have quite a lot of units in these buildings. He's actually at population limit, and Tim is closing into population on 175 right now. We do see light cavalry coming out. They might be trying to pick off some of the trebuchets. There's a lot more coming in, and Tim could be up with Hussar very shortly. I'm just waiting for that to come up pretty soon. These guys are not fully upgraded just yet, but out come the cavalier from Viage. The problem is, can he afford Paladin just yet? No, he cannot. He's going to lose his trebuchets, and that is a huge loss right there. Those trebuchets cost a lot of wood and a lot of gold, and they just got massacred by Mangadai. Mangadai now going to stand in here and do a lot of damage to the cavalier. They might even be able to clear up this army, though it's not looking 100% likely. Tim might have to just retreat with these guys now, as he's starting to be whittled down by the cavalier and these skirmishers at the back. Where is he going? What is he doing? He's taking a lot of fire here, and Tim's population suddenly plummeting down to 160. Viage on 176. He's going to try and replenish his army pretty quickly, I think, but I've got a feeling we could see Paladin fairly shortly. He's getting near to that food mark that he needs, but he did manage to take out one castle from Tim, and that is quite a victory in itself. And he does have a lot of upgrades. He's almost, yeah, he has fully upgraded these Cavalier now, and they are going to be quite formidable, especially if they do get upgraded to Paladin. He could actually afford that fairly shortly. Still waiting for him to do it. But Viage looking pretty strong. He might be adding more skirmishes. I always forget the name of skirmishes. He might be adding more skirmishes in, but at the moment, skirmishes plus cavalier slash end up paladin could be good. I think he might have just upgraded it. There we go. 2-4%. It's a long, long upgrade to do, but if he can keep these cavalier alive, then he will have fully upgraded paladins raiding Tim's base very shortly, and I don't think the Mangadai are going to be able to do enough to defend against it, especially if he adds in elite skirmishes behind, which he is going to be doing. He's continuing to make trebuchets, he's got a castle on the left as well, and Tim is starting to look like he's going to buckle. It's always been in favour of Fiege this entire game, but it's starting to look like Fiege might just be able to push that advantage. It's still not over though. Tim is still looking decent. He's got quite a lot of Mangadai. It's just whether he can make good use of them or do enough with them. Fiege starting to come in now with his cavalier. He's still got a very good economy. He's still got lots of fishing ships on the water, so he will be still gaining a lot of food income. Trebuchet coming out once again, starting to take out the town centre from Tim. He could easily move over and start taking these Mangadai. And how long till Paladin? It's 55%. We will see that fairly shortly. And I think once he gets Paladin and this castle is up and he's got plenty of skirmishes, he will be able to just push on through. And Paladins don't even take that long to take down a town centre from full health, especially considering Tim is not likely to have the upgrades on his buildings. He hasn't got any at all. So buildings pretty weak for Tim. And VA now, with Paladin about to complete, is going to engage right here. I feel pretty confident about this engagement. Tim being forced right back. Paladin is completed, and it looks like he's going to actually pick off a lot of villagers here. If he can just take out the monks as well, he should be okay. Tim with three monks there, getting a nice quick three conversions. And Tim falling back with the Mangadai, doing a lot of damage indeed. And four whole paladins got converted there. That's a big blow to Fiege. Tim falling in population though, still. And it looks like he's going to be a little bit on edge, but he did do significant damage there. Fiege did lose a lot of paladins. He's pretty low on food, but he can afford quite a lot more. He's got a lot of gold in the bank. He just needs more food coming in. And obviously these fishing ships are going to be contributing to a lot of that food income. Economy-wise, he's looking okay, but Tim is still looking fairly strong as well. It's looking like a little bit of a stalemate over here. Where did Tim's Mangadai go? They've moved back over this side, and oh! VH coming in from the side with cannon galleons. He's going to be absolutely wrecking Tim's base right here, and he's going to lose the cannon galleons pretty quickly, but he's also going to lose, or kill even, a lot of Mangadai in the process. The Mangadai sinking the cannon galleons right there, and that was a nice little attack from VH. Managing to kill a few Mangadai in the process, but I don't think he managed to kill enough Mangadai to cover the cost of the cannon galleons there. He's going to have to be careful still because of these monks, but he's still taking out the castles from Tim. He's still repairing his castles as fast as he can, and if he takes out this trebuchet, he could move on to the next castle pretty quickly. He's moving in with more trebuchets now, still making skirmishes, still making paladins, I think, when he can afford it, and even more skirmishes at the back, starting to take Tim's gold as well. And the cannon galleons, what a nice little idea from Fiege. I don't know what damage he managed to do there. He could have killed a few villagers, he could have took out quite a few houses and such, but he didn't end up taking out a town centre. He did, however, manage to clear up this castle. And that is going to prove costly for Tim, because Tim is now not going to be able to keep his Mangadai production up. He's got so much resources though. Look at that, he's got like over 1.5k of everything, but I don't think he's going to be able to spend it very well. His population falling quite rapidly, and VH losing a lot of paladins there, but they are acting as quite a good meat shield as the elite skirmishers fire in from the back and start picking away at the Mangadai very, very quickly indeed. He's going to have to replenish his numbers quite quickly though as well, otherwise he could find himself outnumbered on land and losing his trebuchets once again. He could lose another one right there. That's a little bit costly. Trebuchets are very expensive, and it's not good if you lose them like that. But Fiege now starting to spam a lot more elite skirmishes, more paladins coming out as well. He's still got his two castles standing. Tim unable to take one castle out, still trying to look to pick off these trebuchets, and he's doing a good job of it, making Fiege lose a lot of resources in that, but he lost way too many Mangadai in the process. I think Tim's entire army has been defeated right now. He's down to 100 population, Fiege on 173. and Trebuchet Fire just wreaking havoc on everything, really, starting to take out all the town centers, dealing a lot of damage to the castles. And Tim says GG. He's got no army left and he's got the resources in the bank, but he can't simply spend them. His castles being taken out and the pressure was too damn high. It was looking very favorable for Fiege throughout the entirety of this game. After winning the water, of course, you would expect the player who wins the water to gain a huge advantage and manage to take it from there. But we did see quite an interesting Imperial Age war there with the Mangadai and the Paladins and Skirmishers. It's not something we see all the time and every day, and that was really good. I think maybe if Tim added maybe some onagers in there, he had a lot of resources, he could have afforded some onagers, he would have been able to absolutely flatten the Skirmishers, and then he would have been able to deal with the Paladins. So maybe a little oversight from Tim to add onagers in there. But other than that, Fiege played that excellently, and Tim played pretty well as well. I was a little bit confused as his turtling strategy, but it seemed to sort of pay off. He could have actually won that game if he spent his resources more. I don't think he reached population the entire game, but nice pressure from Fiege as well on the water. But overall, pretty good game. Fiege takes it 1-0, and the next game will be coming up right away.